I talked to a man from Australia 2 days ago, and he was complaining about how life is so much different now in Australia. About 20 years ago, I went to Australia to go on a motorcycle trek. It was a 3,000-mile motorcycle ride in the backland or outland of Australia.
And way in Australia? Way.
Well, it started in Melbourne. And it went out into the back country.
She has a brother studying in Sydney.
This is why I brought that up, because he is here.
You have some cool water?
Oh, I would love to. Yes, I am thirsty.
Filthy. Tonight, I'm at home alone. My wife just left me for a meeting, visiting my children there.
Good.
You want to go out with me around?
I have got to get back to the hotel.
Oh, when?
I don't even know the name of it. It's by the harbor.
Oh, by the harbor.
And
I'll take you there. I'll take you there. By the harbor.
Oh, I will walk. The people I am with want to go to eat.
I see.
So as soon as I get back, we will go out to eat. I told them I would be gone about an hour. It has been an hour.
Yes, okay. So you better take my ride quickly, okay? They're waiting. You are special.
If you want to, I would be happy to.
Okay. Why not? I'm free now today. Stay with them.
Now, there was a young girl. Is that his daughter?
No.
Okay.
He's my teacher.
Okay. How long have you been studying English?
1 week.
Only 1 week?
Yes.
You do very good.
Thanks.
How long have you studied English?
One year.
Okay.
One.
Okay.
Yeah.
And are you in high school? You are a student?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a student.
Now, I am looking here on the top. There is a comparison. And sometimes if you speak, you can mimic the speech pattern, and I don't know what to say. How long has your relative lived in Australia?
Maybe 2 years.
Okay.
Yes.
In the north, in Hanoi, I know people. And the girls have gone to Australia to go to school. So they've been there about 2 years.